Empire, from the Industrial Empire.
Question about the trials. The trials of the Anbiya. Does it mean this is exclusive for the Anbiya only, and human, and the other human beings will not be tried? Of course not. I mean, everybody's going to be tried. The whole purpose of this life is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the greatest actually in trial here, is to prove it, that you worship Allah Azza and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa mentioned in Surah Al-Ankabut, أَلِفْ لَا مِنْ حَسِبَ النَّاسَ وَيُتْرَكُ وَيَقُولُ أَمَنَّ وَهُمْ لَا يَفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, أَلِفْ لَا مِنْ, perhaps those who believe, they think that they will be left to say, I believe or we believe without being tried or tested. And we said they shall be tested just like those who were before them to prove if they were genuine and their belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not. So everybody has to go through trials, and like the Prophet says, Al-Amthal al-Amthal, people they will be tried according to their iman, the strength of their iman. And Allah had mentioned also in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ فَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. We shall try you. We shall try all kinds of trials. بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ means with some, will test you with fear. Some fear, intimidation. You get afraid, you get intimidated by things because of your belief and because of who you are and so on. وَالْجُوعِ, getting hungry. وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ means sometimes will unwind because of actually the decrease of wealth. The decrease of wealth, and that will be another trial actually. وَالثَّمَرَاتِ, food, sustenance. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, and give the good news for those who are patient. Wallahu a'lam. Any question, Jamal? Yes?
What's the meaning of
What's the meaning of that? The question is, what is the meaning of the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Musa alayhi salam to وَضْمُمْ يَدَكَ إِلَى جَنَاحِكَ, means hold your arm or your hand towards جَنَاحِكَ. Now جَنَاحِكَ, another actually ayah, فِي جَيْبِكَ, that you insert your hand in your bosom, means hide it underneath your arm, or hide it inside your throat and then get it out, it will come out bright. Musa alayhi salam was actually dark skinned. So when he pulls his hand out and comes out bright white, it is definitely a miracle for someone. You know, this is not like he's dyeing his hand instantly to change from white to dark again. It's actually a miracle from Allah. It will come out bright for people to see. Wallahu a'lam. Sisters, if you have any questions.
Yeah, Marcus
was Sisters? Any question? Okay, go ahead. The question, first, sisters, if you have no question, please make sure that the microphone is off. Sisters, please make sure the microphone is off. Jazakumullah khair. Okay, the first question from brothers here, do the angels ever get tired? The answer is no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made their qualities so unique that they never get tired. Actually, they never disobey Allah, and they always perform, fulfill all the command that comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your second question?
Why did the Prophet put a stone on his stomach when he was hungry?
Why did the Prophet put a stone on his stomach when he was hungry? To suppress that starvation and hunger, he wants to basically stick his stomach all the way, you know, to his back as much as possible. Basically to press the stomach so he doesn't actually suffer that hunger and starvation. And that is, subhanAllah, something for us is extremely strange, extremely foreign to us. In this day, in this culture, in this age, you cannot even understand what does that mean, because how could this happen anyway? Alhamdulillah, the food is everywhere. You go to Walmart, you go to, you know, Kroger, you have all these foods. So why would you even need to do that? But again, that's unfortunate, an artificial lifestyle that we go through, but the Prophet was doing that to suppress actually that hunger and that starvation, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Any question? Yes?
Intercession or shafa'ah, yeah, I know it's qualities that we are sharing with some of the regular human beings, but is there any difference about the intercession or shafa'ah of the Prophets?
The question is about the Shafa'at al-Anbiya, the intercession. Inshallah ta'ala, perhaps we'll talk about this in the next week when we talk about the exclusive qualities of the Anbiya and what are the things that we're giving to them. Wallahu a'lam. Last question, inshallah.
How do you differentiate between a trial and punishment?
How do you differentiate between trials and punishment? put yourself always between al-raja and al-khawf. It means hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear. So you fear that this is a punishment and you hope that this is a trial from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, you don't even know, because Allah subhanahu will always try you and test you. He will test you whether you're doing good or you're doing bad. If you're doing bad, that is punishment. But how do you know that it's bad? Anyway, Allahu A'lam. And if you were doing good and then you were tested, it's not because you're bad. And because Allah will elevate your status because of these trials. So if you always put yourself between having hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy, and fearing the punishment for something wrong that you've done, inshallah you'll balance that belief. So you won't feel desperate because of what you're going through, suddenly all of a sudden. And you will always have that great hope, inshallah ta'ala, that this is something good for you. And it's always good for the believers, like the Prophet says. عجب لأمر المؤمن. Strange are the affairs of the believers, and it's only for the believers. If it was good, he would be thankful, it would be good for him. And if it was something difficult or hard, he would be grateful, and he would be patient, and it's also good for him. And it's only for the believers, because they always have that positive thinking. And subhanAllah, that's specifically unique, because today people, they always encourage to always keep positive thinking. Positive thinking will lead you, inshallah, to improve the quality of your life or whatever you're going through. Negative thinking, even if you're going through a good time, it's going to turn actually bad. Because when you have negative thinking, you don't know how to utilize that. So even in times of trials, you should always maintain positive thinking. That's between hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy to be a trial, to elevate your status. And keep always the balance by saying, it might be because something wrong that I have done, or something good that I have missed and I haven't done enough. So keep it balanced, inshallah, and that will take you bidna Allah to the next level. Wallahu ta'ala. Khair, inshallah. So next week, we're not going to have a session. We will have actually a break, and bidna Allah will continue the week after that. Subhanakallah wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
ألف لام ميم. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه، هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب.